Well, welcome everyone to Verona, to the Cattolica Center in Verona. We are here day six of the 2018 Junior and Cadet Fencing World Championships. And it's all Sabre team today, men's Sabre team, women's Sabre team. We've fought all the way down to our bronze medal matches. And we've got our women's Sabre team bronze medal match coming up. And it will be Italy facing Korea. For Italy, Giulia Arpino, Lucia Lucarini, Beatrice Dalla Vecchia, and in reserve, Claudia Rotili. For Korea, Kim In-sun, Hong Hyun, Jo Yuan, and in reserve, Lee Seung-mi. And our referees for this bronze medal match from Azerbaijan, Fikret Valiev, and from the USA, Laura Decker. And our lineup for this bronze medal match will be Dalla Vecchia to start for Italy, Lucarini in second, followed by Arpino. It will be Jo Yuan to open for Korea, followed by Kim and Hong in that order. And it, you know, it's always tough to go into a semifinal and lose, as both Italy and Korea did. Korea knocked out by Russia. Italy in a tough, tough battle with, and dramatic battle with the USA. And in the end, it was the USA that prevailed. So, you know, as we know, in these situations, in the tough battle you hope to win, you have to pull yourself together and come out and fight for bronze. There's no joint bronze medals. You've got to have a win in this match to take home a medal. And, you know, it's tough, but everyone is on a level playing field. We get the team salutes. The Italians are always very creative when it comes to that. And the Koreans. I'm David King, and joining me for our matches tonight, Ignacio Casares. Your friends call you Nacho.
Yeah.
But we call you the referee from Spain.
Yeah.
And it's great to have you here. And, you know, this is a really, really long competition.
Yeah, it was crazy. The first 3 days with the pay was long days, that a lot of work. And now with my, I'm a specialist in Sabre, so I enjoy a lot these 3 days, and tomorrow I go back home.
Well, as we get ready to start our first leg, you were a member of the Spanish national team from 1995 to 2008. You're a World Cup medalist. You're an international referee in all three weapons. You know Sabre.
Yeah, and overall Sabre, yeah.
And so, you know, as we get started here, Dalla Vecchia for Italy, Joe for Korea, and Fikret Valiev on to referee for our first two matches. You know, as a referee and as a, you know, as a Sabre fencer, What do you look for in these matches?
Italy lost in his semifinal at the last with US, and for sure they are going to fence really, really aggressive to take another medal for the Italy. Here in Verona, you know, with the people fans at home, try to do his best. The people is here, just cheering them. And I think it will be a great match. The Koreans are always a, they are not anymore a surprise, but in these categories, bring people that nobody knows, and at the end, they are always playing for the medal. So will be a tight match for sure.
Well, we always see that at this competition, at the Cadet and Junior World Championships, because especially in the cadet category, yeah, all of the cadet events are basically in Europe.
Yeah, for sure.
And a lot of the European, of the junior events as well. So fencers come in with a 999 ranking, and then all of a sudden they're on the podium.
Yeah, and can be champions, for sure.
Joe building the attack, Joe finishing the attack.
Yeah, they are, the Korean team are always busted his fencing in the speed. They are so, so fast.
Well, Della Vecchia with the parry there to end our first 5-3. And a fairly evenly pitched first leg. We go into the second. It will be Lucia Lucarini on for Italy and Kim Yun-sun for Korea. And
the referees for this match are Fikrat, Valiev, and Laura Decker. Really? Yeah. Fikrat has a lot of experience in this kind of matches, so he will lead the referee there. He will finish the match for sure. Look, the action. Great attack from Lucarini.
Well, the Italians have come out as if they intend on winning a bronze medal match. The Koreans have something to say about that, but you know, we talk about this every time in a team event, that how difficult it can be,
yeah,
to pull yourself up after a semifinal loss and go out and fight for bronze when you want it to be on the main piece. But everyone, it's a level playing field. Everyone has to do that.
Yeah, but I think for the Italian it will be easy because they have a lot of them have his families here. Support them, and just is a I don't know how to say, a little push more than the Korean, that they lost his semifinal too, and then she had to grow up by herself.
Well, this is our first bronze medal match. Coming up after this, we'll have the USA versus Great Britain.
Amazing performance from Great Britain today. Amazing.
Indeed.
He did a great competition. It was amazing. They beat Germany to go in the top four, and they fenced quite good.
Well, only one in that second for Korea. Kim with 1-5 for Lucarini, and 10-4 we go into the third. It will be Julia Arpino on for Italy and Hong Hyun on for Korea. And the Koreans off to a pretty slow start here.
Yeah,
and you know, if you give Italy the room to get started, is, you know, they're difficult to catch up to, aren't they?
They are difficult, as the Korean coach know already, and he already make a change. I think the second one, because I saw the Korean goes to the referees just to make the change, and I think they are going to change Kim.
Now, that can be either a tactical change to sub out Kim in the fourth leg and then bring her back in.
Yeah, they can do it. They can do it, and people start to using a lot that tactical change. Because can be that you don't feel great with another fencer, so you can come out and then come in with the fencer that you feel great. So the coaches know that, know the preference of his fencers, and try to do his best in the change. But I don't think in this case it's a tactical change. I think Korea needs something more to come back in the game, because 11-5 is too much.
You can't start a match in two legs with 4 points.
Yeah.
And expect to do well. You'll just be chasing the entire time. And it's Italy.
Yeah. They need to push more if they want to win the bronze.
No separation there. Laura Decker on to referee this and the next leg.
Yeah. Laura is a young referee that came in the FI list not so time ago, but he's strong, really, really strong. And as you can see, she's making finals already, and she's so young.
Preparation, Arpino, and Korea showing signs of life here.
Looks at the Korean wake up, man. There will be match.
Well, that is five, now six here in the third for
Hwang.
And this is exactly what Korea needed. Well, Hwang steps in, stops, and Arpino with the cut to end that.
Good, great action. Contre from the left side was great from Arpino. Good long attack.
Well, Arpino seems to have regained her composure here. Final action.
The Italian asked for the video. They think that the answer from Korea, it goes on the blade of the Italian. We will see in the slow motion. We will see. Yeah. I think Laura is right in his decision.
So attack no from Arpino.
There was a blade, but there wasn't a parade from Arpino.
Now that attack goes through, and that will end our third 15-11, but a huge run from Hong Hyun. 7 points there to bring Korea back into this match. Five in it for Julia Arpino. And 15-11, we go into the fourth. Beatrice Della Vecchia back on for Italy, and it will be
Sengun Lee from Korea. This is the change that introduced the Team Korea. We will see what she can do to bring Korea to the match again.
So we have a substitution. We don't know if it's tactical or if it is a full substitution.
We will see after this match.
No separation there.
Premier now. Good, Laura. Lee's not making nothing different than Kim in his first match, so. I suppose that the coach will change again.
Well, it's going to be a real problem for Korea if they're having defense with two fencers.
Yeah.
If two fencers, if their substitute and another fencer, you know, are not carrying their weight, that's going to make for a short match and a long afternoon for Korea.
When you are coming from the bench, you have to be powerful, you have to be on charge, you have to think that you can do it, but it means that the Koreans don't think about that. Maybe I miss, man. He's coming back.
No separation there. And a card coming out for Della Vecchia. Referees, when we had the 64, the quarterfinals going in this hall, the referees were very kind and not many cards because the noise was so great, but the nice bit is over.
The Koreans understand the game right now. To risk this action, to close that match. So at the end it was 5-4, right, David?
That is correct, 4-4 Lee in reserve, Ian, but we don't know if that's a full substitution or a tactical substitution. We shall find out. We go into the fifth, and it will be Arpino on for Italy, and Joe Yuan is back on for Korea, and she will need more, I think, than she had in her first outing. Well, Joe goes looking for the parry, can't find it. Well, she gets it this time, yeah.
Nice attack from the Italian. They work very well, the long attack. They keep the distance till the end. At the end, they push. He has to hit the opponent.
Together.
Yeah. Now coaches are working a lot in the reprise, the attack from the first preparation of the action. It's attack.
Well, again, Jogo's looking for the parry, and it is simply not there. Only two in that for Joe Yuan, and Korea simply can't afford any more.
For the moment, they are out of the game completely. Seitachi looked at the Italians crossing them, and they are going to win the bronze at home.
Lucia Lucarini on for Italy. It is Hong Hyun for Korea. Hong had a very good outing in her first appearance, but she will need a superhuman outing here to do anything to help Korea. And she can't do it on her own. It's a team event.
Yeah, all can happen in team event, you know, David.
Well, Hong steps in, you know, with her arm back, and you can't expect anything other than that to happen. Now, Lucarini, I think, took a shot to the hip.
Yeah.
I think the blade must have whipped around, and that stings, doesn't it?
That hurts.
Yeah.
It's in an expected part of your body, because from when you get usually the touches, your skin is habituated to the touches, but when you take it in another part, yeah, it hurts. But his confidence is great today.
Well, Hong has her first. here in the sixth. No separation there, but I mean, it's going to be very difficult for Korea at this point. Hong asked for a video review here. I suppose she might as well ask for a video review rather than just leave it. No change.
No change.
Well, they've used their challenge. There's nothing she can do about it. And that will do it. 30-19. We go into the seventh. But
he's going again to check or just to change the referees. No, he's not going to check. The vote is finished. Yeah. That's it.
Well, what are they doing?
Because they come to make the change with Laura for the referees for the next match, but the fencer think that he's going to
the video
to check the relaxation, but it's not because the Korean missed his challenge already.
All right, starting the seventh and all important seventh, eighth, and ninth legs.
Yeah, the last round.
We've got. Lee is still in, so that was a permanent substitution. Lee, the reserve, in for Kim Yun-sun, but Lee didn't have much more success than the person she replaced.
Yeah.
Only two in that for Hong.
She make four at the first league. She fence. But she start late. Do you remember that she start like 4-0 or 3-0, something like that?
Yeah.
And then come back a little bit. We will see if now she has more confidence, look like this.
So they're having a look at the video here.
Yeah.
And we see the replay. And it, you know, when you've got the replay from the end of the piece, that makes it really difficult when you can't see any of the actions.
Yeah, it's quite difficult. The Italian asked for the video again. Laura speak with Fricat. Fricat disagree, looks like. So I think Laura keep the decision. Good. Looks. Yellow card.
No, she's. No. I think she just said, let's get on with it.
But well done, Laura. Korea want to fight right now, but I think maybe it's too late. But I feel that they changed his mind. They now want to fight more than in the beginning.
Well, like you say, there's a point at which it's very difficult to recover. And waiting until the seventh leg of a nine-leg match is pushing it.
But this is Sabre, David, don't forget it.
Well, that's,
can happen.
I thought that was Epe where everything could happen. Can it happen in Sabre too?
Overall in Teen Event, because in Epe Teen Event, they keep more time, they keep more the distance between the touches. So it's more difficult, made a lot of touches against minus touches.
Right.
But in Sabre, it's everything quickly. If you load your confidence for 30 seconds, you can get 6 or 7 touches on a roll.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's, look at that, man.
Well, this is interesting. She's run off 6 points.
The Italian is lucky right now because he arrives to 34 and she just needs one touch to close the match. But
all right, so the reserve, Lee Sung-mi, has come out and gone on a bender here.
You saw at the beginning the quarterfinal match between Russia and France. Russia was leading 44-36.
Yeah, yeah.
At the end, it was 44-44.
Pianfetti did an amazing thing there.
Pianfetti was an amazing performance today.
And he was up against Lokanov, who's the junior world champion.
Yeah.
Two-time world champion.
But remember that Pianfetti is the European champions 2 weeks ago in Sochi.
But now it's interesting here because, you know, Arpino needs one, and she has gotten nothing lately, and you can tell she's rattled, so she comes off the piece to tie her shoe and give herself a moment to think about that. We talk about that up here all the time, about, you know, what device? Is it hair? Is it shoes?
And, stop.
You know, it's what
again
they
and
do.
Again.
Well, after an amazing run, are we going to have a challenge here? We will not. But that was a great run from Lee Sung-mi, the reserve, who comes in on a 9-5 run. Is it enough to do anything for Korea here? You know, I don't know, but we know that Korea is not going to give up.
It's a saying that Koreans start to fend right now, because if they are start at the beginning, we will enjoy a great, great bronze medal match.
Well, we may have one yet. Beatrice Della Vecchia on in the eighth, and it will be Hong Hyun. We know that Hong can hold her own. Let's see what we get here. Interesting.
Yeah. It's very important the first 2-3 touches for the Italians to keep the distance.
Well, Hong with a lovely looking plunge, but Della Vecchia takes a step out of distance.
Keep the distance perfectly.
And then steps back in to get the hit.
Yeah.
It's still, Ignacio, this is all of a sudden a 6-7 point match.
Yeah.
When a minute ago we were thinking it's all done and dusted.
There are 8 touches. It's not so much, but I feel the Italians fencing well. Now Giovanni Cirovic asks for the video. Say to his fencer, ask, and Laura is going to check it. Oh, from behind, in this, it's difficult to see. Good attack. Really, really good.
We're on even pegging here. 3 for Hong, 3 for Della Vecchia. Important hit there for the Italian. No separation.
The Korean asked for the video. They think about, they have the reason with the reprise attack. We will see what decide between Laura and Fikrat. And they were right.
Yeah, good call. She'll get to keep that challenge.
Yeah.
Again. Della Vecchia using distance well on that plunge that Hong has tried twice now.
Yeah.
And it just falls short.
Absolutely. The Korean girl, it was out of distance both times, and Della Vecchia kept the distance perfectly to make the touch. 40-32.
So four there for Hong, five for Della Vecchia. We go to the ninth and final leg. Lucia Lucarini on to close for Italy, and Joe Yuan for Korea.
Lucarini made third place in the junior competition, if I don't remember. If I remember well, not. I think he was bronze medal, yeah.
For this year?
Yeah. And for sure she wants to take another bronze medal in his neck today, in her neck, excuse me.
Yes, I believe you're correct. Joe looking for the parry. Not there.
Correct. Lucia determined to win this medal. Same action. Pare riposte. And finish. Italy win the bronze medal.
Well, after a difficult day, Italy digs deep, pulls it out, 45-34. The scoreline looked like it was going to be completely different early on in the match when we thought that Korea would simply collapse, but they fought back. They ran out of time. They shouldn't have left it as late as they did. But an excellent match for Italy, and they'll be on the podium later. And you know, it's a home world championships. And, you know, it counts.
That will be our big, big, big match. Russia-Italy, a classic match for finals in all weapons, all categories.
Well, we've seen that matchup before, and it's always great.
I saw them a lot of time fencing together.
Well, we've got our second bronze medal match to come. That will be between Great Britain and the USA. And, you know, we talked about, Ignacio, how Britain had such a great day. I mean, you can't categorize it any other way. Great Britain. And in the men. And let me see, which one do I have up here?
They working hard for a long time. And here is the result. That's it. It was a really nice surprise for me. One of the coaches is a good friend of mine, and I saw him, like, he worked really, really hard, and he pushed to the Team GB to this bronze medal match.
But the
it looks like the US is more habituated to make that kind of matches, but don't forget, we are in a junior category and everything can happen here too. And Team GB beats Germany, if I remember well.
Well, they started off against Saudi Arabia.
Yeah.
That was a close match, but they won 45-36. Then they took out Japan.
Japan, yeah. Japan, remember that is preparing the Tokyo 2020 games, and they put a lot of money fencing too, to great coaches. They have the Korean coach that was world Olympic champion in London. They have already in Japan, and they are improving a lot.
Well, then Great Britain faced Germany with that has Raul Bona,
Yeah.
And Heathcock, is it Heathcliff? What's his name?
Bona, Raul Bona.
Raul Bona. And Raul then Bona. Antonio, I think it's Antonio Heathcliff or something like that. But anyway, he's very talented.
Yeah.
And you know.
And then.
They beat them. They beat Germany.
Yeah.
And in
a great country, great tradition.
In the semifinal.
German teams are always strong. Even if they don't have a great individuality, they always, as a team, as a strong team that counts for all the medals, all everything. And now they are out. And Team GB is in.
Well, the thing that, you know, the USA faced China. They beat them. They faced Korea. They beat them. They got into the quarterfinal. They faced Belarus. They beat them. They went into the match with Italy. In their head, they're thinking, we can beat Italy.
Yeah, because they were close till 33 or something like that. They were close.
And
but you said about
Great Britain went into a match with Russia, and I don't think they thought, we're not going to beat Russia. Let's get the athlete introductions here. That's Halliwell, Edwards, Suddards, and Nicholas Howes in as reserve. For the USA, it is Andrew Dotto, Erwin Kai, Kamar Skeet, and in reserve, Mitchell Sharon. And our referee for this evening, Andrea Duana of Romania, Pascal Cantin of Canada.
Andrea Doana was is his wife name, because she was at the beginning, he was Andrea Pele. She was a great fencer from Romania, sabre fencer. And she's a good referee too.
Exactly.
And right now, I have to say, she's pregnant. She's 5 months pregnant. She's expected a baby, a man. And for sure, he will be a good fencer.
Has no choice.
Yeah.
They come out for the team salutes. The point I was trying to make, Ignacio, is that when Great Britain faced Russia, they were not mentally tied to a win in that game because they knew how difficult it would be to beat Russia. The USA faced Italy. They thought they could beat Italy.
For sure.
So mentally, I'm thinking that Britain is thinking ahead to the bronze medal match and preparing themselves for that, while the USA is mentally tied up with the semifinal.
Yeah.
Does that give Britain an advantage from your standpoint?
Yeah, at that point, I think the Great Britain have more confidence to this match than the US. But will be a tie match for sure.
All right, it is Suddard to open for Britain, followed by Edwards and Halliwell. For the USA, it will be Kemar Skeet to open, followed by Dotto and Kai.
They make a change, USA. I think they changed from the Italian match. Because at the Italian match, I think Kai closed the match against Neri. And right now, they put it a Skeet that, remember, he has a cadet, a big cadet, but he's a cadet.
Well, Mitchell Sharon did really well in the for the USA in the Italy match.
In the Italy match.
And
maybe they are keeping him and introduce later with a tactic change.
Could be.
What do you think?
I don't know, but we'll find out. Andrea Duana to referee the first two legs of this bronze medal match. And a young and hungry team from Great Britain, having had great success today. Let's see how up they are for this, because the USA team will not want to leave Verona empty-handed.
Yeah, for sure. It's very, very important, the first matches. Good.
It's good distance management there from Sutterds.
Sutterds,
come
yeah.
forward.
I was referring him in the individual competition. He beats Poznikov, one of the best Russians. He beats in top 32, making a good fencing. I never seen before this guy.
Sutterds with the parry.
Yeah. Great attack from Skeeter.
A little mini flunge there at the end. And a Skeet giving a big yell.
Attack to Lalin, nice touch. Lalin is always a nice touch. It looks like it all times.
Yeah, but it's quite difficult to get it correct, isn't it?
Yeah, it's almost impossible.
Well, Andrea Duano.
Lalin Tous, yeah.
Walked over to speak to Pascal Cantin and review the video. And when she got there, he didn't even look up. He just went... held his arm out and said, yes, that's a correct call.
Yeah, yeah. When you are in the video, you have to pay attention that happened in the piste. But you are, maybe I can say, more quiet than the main referee. So you have another point of view. You are more quiet because you are not in the middle of the match.
Right,
and you can give another point of view to the main referee that is very useful.
All right, we start the second. It will be James Edwards in for Great Britain and Andrew Dotto for the USA.
Edwards, he make a good fencing today. I saw before. And maybe he's the more confidence in herself for the Team GB. We will see what happened now.
Preparation Edwards, Dotto with he is first here. Edwards threw on the attack.
Yes.
Oh, lovely parry there from Edwards. You know, I was about to say the U.S. seems like they've come out meaning business, but. You know, the
we are still close.
What I have seen from Britain today is that they remain calm.
Yeah.
And they get down and they pull themselves back into the match. And, you know, I haven't seen them panic at any point. Or
man, they don't have nothing to lose today. It's all winning. And they have to use that to go on top.
No card.
Right. Right, and he knows, accept the decision with the finger. Great touch. Great distance, keep it by Dotto. But at the end, the British guy hit him.
Quite an exchange there.
10-6. We are, I think, exactly the same. 5-3, 5-3 it was.
Yes. You know, I'm normally very efficient when it comes to writing things down, and for some reason I forgot to write down the first leg. We go to the third. It will be
Pascal
Barnaby Halliwell on for Britain, and Erwin Kai for the USA. And it will be Pascal Quentin on to referee the next two legs. See, you look at, you know, the USA has come out strong. They have been reasonably clean and crisp to an extent here. If you are on, if you were going to give some advice to the British side about what to do next, what would it be?
I say to them that trust in themselves, because they arrive by themselves here. They, as I told you before, they don't have nothing to lose. Just have to enjoy and try to do his best fencing. They can do it, and then they know how to do, because they did already during the day. So just enjoy, don't feel pressure, nothing. For them, it's already great, be even fourth in this world championship.
Yeah.
But they can do bronze. Why don't try to get it? But to get it, they have to have confidence and just play. That's it.
Well, it's early in the match, and
they are good. If they leave, the Americans take more points in advance, will be difficult, as we see before in the semifinal for the women's. They had to keep the distance.
Now, Erwin Kai asking for a video review here.
I wait to see the video here, even if he's from behind.
No,
I don't have the chance.
The call stands.
Pascal, keep the touch. Oh,
everybody's missing.
Yeah.
And Pascal Quentin's going to go straight over and have a look at this. There were 2 points of contact, I felt, as Halliwell was clinging to the back line.
Pascal Quentin is going to check if the British parried. Yeah.
Mal parry.
No parry. Because he tries at the end to make a parry, but it was mal parry. Pascal said. I think he was right.
All right, well, two in it there for Halliwell, and five for Erwin Kai. Something needs to happen for Britain to get back into this match, and it needs to happen right about now.
Yeah, absolutely agree. I'm going to say the same. This match is very important. They had to keep to put some touches in advance. If not, it's done. Replace the attack, the gross.
Nicely composed attack there from Sutterds.
Oh, yellow card. The false start, it's right now people use like in advance. So we referees have to really cut that with the cards.
We've seen a lot of them here.
Yeah, of course. Because when people have a yellow card, he think about it. He don't want, because the next one it will be red, and it will be a touch.
Well, we have seen matches ended on red cards a couple of times in the past 2 days.
Yeah.
Well, there was no place else to go for George Suttert.
Yeah. Good, great para repose. Good preparation and great dodo in fourth para and repose. Great. Attack from the left side, good. Now he's leading 5-3, I think.
He is.
This kind of match is that we want to see.
Britain climbing right back into this match. We said at the beginning of this fourth leg that if something was going to happen, it needed to happen now, and it appears to be.
They are knocking the door, man. Oh. As for the video, he thinks the attack from the American hits
in the guard
before touch. We will see. Pascal say that not and give the attack for the Americans. Oh, yellow card for the
I believe
left
that Mr.
side.
Suttert.
Finish the league. Yeah. It was.
Well, the fourth leg ends on a penalty, 2014, and not a bad outing there for Suttert, but only a net pickup of one.
Yeah.
And they'll need more than that. It will be Kamar Skeet back on for the USA, and he will face Barnaby Halliwell.
I saw Skeet during these 3 days. He's hungry. He's a fencer that wants everything, every time. He's a fighter. Did you see? He's out before the start. It's like crazy.
Well, good.
Yeah. He's very, very focused.
I can see Halliwell's coach up and signaling to him to try and settle down a bit.
Yeah.
He is pumped up.
Amazing parry pose. I think it was a little bit luckier, but it comes to.
I would have liked to have seen the look on Andrea Duana's face when he did that just then.
Yeah.
I think it might have said very clearly, go back to your line. Well, he went looking for the parry.
Yeah.
And it was not there.
Asking for the video. The Briton thinks his attack is on time. And we will see what happened now. Attack from the right side. The jump have this problem. When you are jump, you don't keep well the distance. Look, Skeety, what amazing leg.
Well, I mean, the both of them, Skeet and Halliwell, they seem to be electrified in some way.
Yeah.
Well, that will end the fifth, 25 for the USA, 15 for Britain, only one in it for Halliwell. And you're not going to get a bronze medal that way. It will be in the sixth. It will be James Edwards. Is it James Edwards? James Edwards for Great Britain, Irwin Kai. Is back on for the USA. It will be Edwards to close for Britain and Kamar Skeet to close for the USA.
Yeah, right.
First attack, no. Second attack, no.
Yeah, that the British don't answer. So the repeated attack from the right side, it was good. Even this time. It is, man. Go to the line. He broke his saber.
You'll have to surrender that and take a new one.
John Salfield, ex-fencer, coach of the British team. Great, great player of guitar.
Yeah, he's a flamenco artist,
flamenco.
Isn't he?
Yeah.
Do you approve of that, being Spanish?
It's impossible. I just won't see. That's it. But he plays amazing. Come back in fencing.
Edwards, looks like he turned his ankle. Well, we can see here.
Yeah. I think Americans are on fire. They are running from the bronze. It's incredible how many people see this YouTube channel.
It's quite a lot.
Yeah.
Quite a lot of people.
I have my phone over here. And I'm receiving a lot of messages from Colombia, from whatever. Hey, are you making the commentator guess in there?
We have a very large audience.
Yeah.
If you, you know, you, when you're watching, you see, like on the screen right there,
yeah,
it says 623. It's not 623. That's how many people are clicking on this channel in that moment.
Uh-huh.
The numbers are much, much bigger.
Yeah. I just received a message from a Colombian saber fencer, Carlos Valencia, that is watching the wars from Colombia.
I've received a lot of very interesting messages from very interesting people in odd places who are watching.
It's good, great job, David. This is great for fencing, that everybody can see what happened here in Verona.
That's the point, Nacho. Yeah. We want people to watch fencing.
Good.
30-16, it's all sort of coming apart here for Britain, but you know, you've said it, Nacho, that they're gonna go away, if this continues, they're gonna go away in fourth place at the World Championships. What's wrong with that?
Nothing.
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 Exactly.
Nothing.
They'll have something really solid to build on. And go into the next season with.
Yeah, I think so.
All right, Halliwell on in the seventh for Britain, Andrew Dotto for the USA. That
looks like, you know, when you all you can try come on, and the Americans are in that situation right now. All they can try is good,
yeah.
And for the British, they try to change, and nothing works really good. So they are a big distance, almost double. It would be very difficult to come back in the game from the British. Great attack from Dodo.
The first attack, no. For Dotto,
yeah.
And Halliwell. Halliwell chases him to the back line, but can't finish.
They try, but Nothing it works for the British in this bronze medal match.
Well, that will do it for the seventh, and we roll into the eighth. Only two in that for Halliwell, and you know, it's a great experience for them.
Yeah, but they make just four touches from the last four games.
Yeah, that won't do it. Erwin Kai on in our eighth and penultimate leg to face George.
Penultimate, yeah.
Sutters.
It will be Sutters. They don't change still the. No. Wait.
Card coming out for Kai.
From the American touch in the leg of the British.
Well, Sutter's looking for a parry in there, and I think basically he ended up with a sore hand.
Try acrobatic action, Sutters, but no way. It's finished.
That'll do it for the eighth. USA cruising to victory here. Three in it for Sutters. And we go to the ninth and final leg. Kemar Skeet on to close for the USA. And James Edwards in for a British team that has had moments of brilliance today, knocking out Saudi Arabia, then Japan, then Germany, and a semifinal loss to Russia. And they don't seem very happy, just looking down at their end of the, at their end down there, they don't seem very happy, but
yeah, no.
You know, they'll get over it because they finished in fourth place at the World Championship.
Yeah, but now they are understand that maybe it was a good chance to take a medal. Who knows what will happen again?
Yeah.
You have to be always ready to fight and ready to win. I don't say the British don't fight today, but I think they need more confidence in themselves. Attack the rod. Correct.
Well, they've got something to build on in terms of confidence. They can leave this and say, you know what, we actually can win.
Yeah, can happen, and they can do it. I'm sure of that.
Parry, counter parry.
Let me know, how many touches take a Skeety today in this match?
Skeet.
Four. That's four touches, man. Till the moment.
Sutter's.
Four touches. Skeety. Till this moment. We have get only four touches.
Yep.
These kind of people for the teams are amazing. Are like a wall. Nobody can touch me.
Well, that will do it. 45-21, the USA takes home the bronze medal. Nil point in the final leg for Edwards.
But I think the referees are still watching the
video.
The video, and the fans is already give shaky hands.
What would they be looking for?
I don't know. I don't know exactly because. It's finished. Bronze
okay.
for the United
right.
States.
It's now settled.
Now we start with the most important matches of the day, the gold medals.
We've got two
great matches.
Two world champions to crown, and we're going to do that starting in just a few minutes. USA will face Russia in the women's saber team event, and then Russia will face Italy in the men's saber team event.
Will be a big show.
Well,
you will see.
What are our chances of hearing the Russian national anthem again tonight? Might be pretty good. We'll
yeah,
see.
Could be.
We certainly have not heard the USA national anthem, and we have heard Fratelli d'Italia several times here, the Italian national anthem. But
did you hear it already?
Yeah, we've had it. But right now we're going to take a short break and get ready for the gold medal matches. They'll be coming right up. So stay with us. We'll be back. Welcome back, everybody. We've got a couple of gold medal matches to get through. This is day six, and it's our final saber day. We've had individual juniors, individual cadets, and it is our one team day here in Verona. First up, we've got the women's saber team matchup, USA versus Russia. And Zara Moss for the USA, Edith Johnson Elizabeth Tartakovsky, and in reserve, Chloe Fox-Gittimer. She was injured in the semifinal match against Italy. Russia, Evgenia Podpeskova, Olena Mikhailova, Olga Nikitina, the junior world champion, and in reserve, Valeria Kobzeva. And our referees for this gold medal match, Vincenzo Constanzo and Miklos Kosa of Hungary. And Lee Bak Nguyen and Laura Decker. Well, that's not Laura Decker. Well, that's what's written on there. Will be our assessors for this match. Our running order is Tartakovsky to open for the USA, Edith Johnson in second, and then Zara Moss. Olga Nikitina will open for Russia, followed by Podpeskova and Mikhailova. Johnson will close for USA. Nikitina will close for Russia. And, you know, interesting matchups. There was a real drama in the match between Italy and the USA in the semifinal. In the eighth leg, there was a huge collision of guards. And I believe that it was Arpino that was up against... Arpino that was up against... Fox-Gittimer, and Fox-Gittimer took some terrible shot and ended up flat on her back on the piece, had to be taken off. We had a medical timeout. She had to be taken off, couldn't continue. Zara Moss came in and did the job for the USA. They went on to win, but Chloe Fox-Gittimer is on the bench, as they say tonight, due to that injury that she suffered in the semifinal. We get our team salutes and team huddles, and our referee for the first two legs will be Vincenzo Costanzo. David King here with you, and I am joined again this evening by Ignacio Nacho Casares,
good.
The great referee from Spain, fencer in his own right.
You are too kind with me.
Not in the least. Big match up here between Nikitina and Tartakovsky, probably the two strongest fencers for both sides. What do you make of this matchup and this competition?
The Russian team is so strong. Nikitina, under that face, that girl that never broke a disc, it's a fighter, great fencer. She's the world champion already. Tartakovsky, it was a race here, like one of the top of the ranking, of the world ranking.
She was number 12 coming in.
She make a great season, but don't take a medal here, so for sure.
Yeah, she had a tough match against Larissa Eifler in the round of 64 in the individual event. And Eifler went on to reach the quarterfinal. But, you know, if you're up against Olga Nikitina, you are in a battle.
Yeah. Miklos Kosa is refereeing the first two leagues. Referee from Hungary. He was a good serve fencer too. And he retired so young. He has to be, for me at this moment, maybe the best referee in the world. At least top three. You never can say the best, but he's in top three for sure.
So who else would you put in that top three?
in the referees, it's hard. But Mickey will be in the top for sure. Basile, Marius, Pape too.
Yeah.
There are a great group of referees right now in the Sabre that are doing well his job, and for the fans that are great, because there are not so many mistakes. And for the fans, it is good that less mistakes, more fencing, more confidence, and more good touches.
A strong start for Nikitina here in the first of this gold medal match.
Yeah, but we are at the beginning. We will see the first round, the first three matches.
Yep.
We will define a little bit, will be the way of the match.
Tartakovsky through on the attack with her third. Well, that will end the first three for Tartakovsky, five
for Nikitina.
For Nikitina, and we will go to the second, and it will be Edith Johnson on for the USA, and she will face Evgenia Podpeskova. The one thing you can count on, for the most part, with Russian fencers is they're going to be tall. Not necessarily always giants like Lokanov, but they're going to be tall.
Yeah, but Nikitina is not tall, and you will see. I think both countries have his faces painted with the national flag.
Yep.
That it's a demonstration of how much they want to want for that countries. Good, great attack from Johnson. See a great match, David.
Edith Johnson really, really doing well here.
Yeah. She's coaching by Darius Gilman, a Pollock's ex-saber fencer that goes to make the Americas, to US, and now he's coaching there.
Lovely parry riposte, a strong one.
She tries again, but it's too much, three in a row. Finish the second leg. 10-8 for the Russian. It will be a very interesting match. Now they change the referees. Vincenzo Costanzo comes, and for him it will be, if I remember good, it's his first World Championship final in his career.
This is?
Yeah, this is. Right now, he's going to start the first match in a final World Championship for him.
Is he nervous, do you think?
For sure, he's nervous, as all of us, when we are refereeing a big match. But he's really, really good. The Italian traditional referee said that all the referees that arrive to the FI list are good referees. And he's one of these. He's the last to arrive, but look at him. He's already in the finals.
And already handed out his first yellow card
yeah.
in the finals.
But it's not nice. The referees, we don't like to use the cards, but it's our weapon, you know? It's our weapon to keep the clear the peace with the coaches and everything.
Zara Moss coming out like she left off in the semifinal, strong and competent. Still Moss's attack. No separation there.
Good, amazing time in the middle. Moss was an incredible job in the box.
That
she killed
7 points.
Yes, she killed the Russian in the middle of the strip.
7-2 run for Zara Moss. And now Tartakovsky will be back on for the USA. And she'll be up against Podpeskova. But that was a pretty incredible turnaround there. We've seen three legs.
Yeah.
Nacho, what do you know, you said we'll know what kind of match we're gonna have. What kind of match are we going to have?
We are going to have a great match. I suppose that we will arrive to the end very, very close. Don't pay attention to the channel. Don't lose nothing. Maybe the Americans, his fencing is more basic in the physical condition. They are more strong than the Russians, and the Russians maybe they are more technical than the US. There are two ways of arrive.
Tartakovsky has caught the fire from Moss and Johnson, and if the U.S. can keep this sort of adrenaline rush going, it's going to be tough for the Russians, and we know the Russians are tough.
But the Russians still fight.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And Jerry Gilman saw to the American fencer to keep the line. And one more time, attack over the preparation in the middle.
Well, five there for Tartakovsky, and another tough.
The Americans are making a great job in the box.
Another tough outing there. The Russians had two in the third, three in the fourth, and
US 12.
It's a good thing for Russia that Olga Nikitina is coming back on in the fifth. She'll face Zara Moss, but somebody needs to calm the Russian side. Video review being called. What was the call that Miklos Kosa made just then?
Miklos Kosa said that the please defer from the American touch before on the guard, and then Nikitina answer. Miki in that case is very, very fine, and really he keep the decision. Okay.
Okay, Nikitin is attacked there.
I make Russia back a little bit. Good attack from Sara.
Card coming out for Nikitina. Won't be any hit given there. Nikitina holding her own here, as you would expect from the junior world champion. Miklos Kosa is going to go have a look at this.
Yeah, they have a doubt. Nikitina tries to make up her end the second during the attack on Sara. I think Miki watched it. It was Malpare. He saw something strange, and he wanted just to be sure of his feelings.
Well, as he went to the scoring table, he said Le Même Chose, the same thing.
Yeah.
But didn't make the call.
They are going to see a couple of times, maybe, just to be sure. And right now, he takes the parade. 4-4 in this league.
What is... Something has come apart. Mm-hmm. But we don't know what.
No, we didn't see.
Big, big attack there from Zara Moss to take us out of the fifth leg. And the USA team is looking not only strong and confident, but their game is going right.
Yeah.
And the Russians, you know, there will come a time, and maybe it's right now, where the Russians start a massive fight back. But up to this point, it's been a really strong outing for the U.S.
Yeah, I think so. I think the Russians are just fencing. I didn't see they don't lose that 1-1. For sure they won't, but don't demonstrate. They have to do more fencing. Maybe it's not the moment. Whoa, amazing, Paré Riposte.
You know, who she reminds me of a bit is Natalia Botello.
Yeah, whoa, that's incredible fencer. Amazing. Natalia Botello is already, last year, I think she was the only one that was three times in the podium. She was in junior, yes. Cadets, and teams.
Yeah, yeah. She was junior world champion when she was 14.
14, yeah. Yeah.
Silver this year and bronze this year.
No, two silvers this year. I think.
No.
No, sure?
Sure. Silver and bronze.
Yeah, you are right. She lost against Putztai in the semifinal in Cadet.
Yeah.
No.
Russians The Russians are in trouble. And Mikhailova has broken her blade. She's going to have to get a new one. But
Botella won two silvers. Check it.
I'll check it.
Check it. He win put side in Kadet in the semifinal and go to the final against Nikitina, right?
That's correct. She picked up silver in the juniors and was knocked out.
And lost with put side and the and final in cadets.
No.
No, in juniors.
Semifinal.
Sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I will check.
Yeah.
Just check. To make you happy.
Nice counterattack at the end of the piece. Very nice. Mikhailova is fighting. Just for touches. Five. Whoa, Johnson is on fire today.
She is. Especially in this match. Mikhailova trying to arrange her shoelace.
Yeah.
And that will do it. A big, big outing there. Just building on the confidence for the U.S. team. And five in that for Johnson. Well, let's get the official word here. But five for Johnson, five for Mikhailova. 30-24, we go into the seventh. This is where it all happens, isn't it? Seventh, eighth, and ninth.
Yeah.
And anything that's happened before, you can just throw out the window pretty much.
Yeah.
But it's a six-point USA lead. What do you think Russia needs to do to get back into this match?
Looks like the 6 points, it will be pretty much right now. Because the U.S. are fencing really strong and the Russians don't look like. So it will be depends about the three, four touches, first touches right now in this league. We will see what happened after. Yellow card for the Russian. Or false start.
Nacho,
right now will be yellow card for the American.
You were right. I went and checked the results, and I've seen so many matches that they all sort of blend in together. But it was Pustai and
Mateo
in the gold medal match.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're right, two silvers.
That's the mother, man. It's incredible that you remember all that you remember,
that
remember already, man.
That I remember anything.
Yeah. Looks two touches in a row for the...
Yeah, well, it's not just that. It's the fact that Zara Moss has given up a hit on a penalty.
Yeah, a red card for false start.
She hasn't scored yet. And this could be where the Russians start to make a move.
Yeah. Look, 30-27.
Yeah, it used to be a 6-point match. It's now three.
And for the fencer, you have a card and you are then on the top, you are nervous. And the false start, it's a penalty that can give back the other team in the game.
Yep.
No. Russian is risking about that. Reprise the attack on the right side. Looks like the Russian right now is more focused than Sara. Attack again. We have match.
Wow. Popescova thought she had the hit. She did not. And they're looking pretty uncomfortable over in the American box.
Yes, she's working great in the reprise the attack. After the preparation, he makes a lot of touches like that. When they move over the piece, I think the advantage is for the American girl. But in the box, with the reprise attack,
no.
Look, she tries again. It is attack again. If the American want to finish this match, she can't to move more. Attack again. Again and again.
Well, she needs to get out of the box. And the coaches, the American coaches, I see them back in the back move.
I saw jury that said, get out from there. Not anymore in the middle. Now 34-34. As we expect, we have match.
She stays in.
At the end, and she understand.
Well, that's a big swing there. Six for Popescova. Five for Moss.
Eight.
One of those points came on a penalty.
On a penalty. So it was six. Real touches was six. And two penalties?
Ten. Five for Moss, five for Popescova, and the penalty gift.
Yeah.
So 35-34 is very different from 30-24. We go into the eighth and penultimate leg. Elizabeth Tartakovsky on for the USA and Elena Mikhailova for Russia.
Both made the same. The American girl take the fair, and the Russian try to make the parade. Good. Look to her bench. Just watch the video or not.
That's still Mikhailova's attack.
Yeah, 37-37.
You said you felt like we were going to be close, that we were going to be close all the way to the end. And
there was a time that it don't look like, because the Americans were fencing great, but the Russian back, and it will be close. The last match will be great.
Yeah, let's see what score we have to end of the eighth.
It will be 40-37. Great attack.
40-37, and it is Tartakovsky who comes back in and steadies the ship. for the USA. Olga Nikitina will be on to close for Russia, the junior world champion. For the USA, it would be Edith Johnson, and she has been fencing like a demon tonight.
Yeah, I think today, Johnson, it was the best fencer during this day. Nikitina knows how to win in this piste already. So we will see a very great league right now. The last touches for the gold medal match. Nikitina know how to do, but Johnson want to know how.
Miklos Kosa, our referee for this ninth and final leg, gold medal match, world championship.
Mickey is safe in these situations.
What are they looking for here?
We will see.
Los Cosa coming back.
Yeah. It was. Nikitina looks more quiet than the American.
Well,
now
Johnson has barely moved off the line
good.
So far, and she's got to do something.
But she did a lot of actions before, but right now she just go. She had to do fencing, you know. Right now she makes a great parry riposte, but if he are going just some. And go, and go, and go. She's going to lose in that way.
Okay.
Like that is the only way to win. You have to make fencing. Fencing is not run. Fencing is make parry riposte, take risk, and that make the champions.
Alrighty.
Good. She's back.
How will Nikitina respond?
With attack. Yeah.
This is going to be a battle right down to the end. Who's going to deliver the knockout punch? All right. Russia needs one to win. USA must have one to tie.
Great. Reprise the attack on the left side. Great.
Here we go. 44-44 gold medal match. Nikitina asking for a video review.
Yeah. Remember that there are right now with 44-44, the referee have to go for sure to the video.
Yep. Cannot end the match without the referee referring to the video.
Yeah. Even if it's clear, he have to. And it was. Mickey goes to the video anyway. Confirm that everything is right.
This is a single light.
Russia.
Our 2018 Women's Sabre Team World Champions.
Yeah,
the
Nikitina,
team from Russia.
Nikitina come back for the 40-37 at the beginning of the league to the 44, excuse me.
But what a great match. That was a great match.
Yeah, it was
it?
was great. The Russians start to fence when they won, they start to fence, and they come back to win. And Nikitina, double junior world champion. What do you think, David?
I think that's a pretty good thing to come away with. You know, while we've got a minute, Nacho,
but
you know, this format that we've got, 3 days of épée, juniors, individual, cadet, and then team. We've got one more match to wind up Sabre. Then we'll have foil starting tomorrow.
Yeah.
But let's look at the first 3 days, and what do we see? We see Davide DiVaroli.
DiVaroli, yeah.
Okay, you're a fencer, you're a referee, okay? He comes in, does the pools, fences all day to the last match, and comes away with the silver medal.
Yeah.
He goes home, he gets some sleep, he gets up in the morning, he comes back here, he does the pools all day long and fences to the last match, and he takes home a gold medal.
A gold medal.
Then he gets up the next day, comes in here for the team event, and fences all day to the next to the last match, and takes away a bronze medal.
Amazing performance.
How do you do that? How do you do that?
You are training during the year for this. I think for these categories, for these guys like Davide that is cadet, it's pretty hard. Fence 3 days on a roll and achieve that incredible results.
Well, I think the only reason that we don't see Liza Pushka and Natalia Botello, you know, in here is because, you know, the teams.
Yeah, the team. There are three people in the team.
Not that strong. They were both out early.
Yeah.
So. But, I mean, I've heard some comments that, you know, from coaches and athletes saying that it's very difficult on the cadets. But it also opens up opportunities. It's difficult.
Yeah, because the cadets are not habituated to fence even 2 days on a run, because his competition used to be just 1 day and that's it. Junior and seniors are habituated to make 2 or 3 days. Both, because a lot of junior fans in senior World Cups that start on Friday and finish on Sunday, a lot of them fence the 3 days. So they are more habituated, like Lokanov. Lokanov is a fencer that used to be in the senior circuit. So for him, it's different way.
Yeah.
But for the cadets, I think it's amazing. Only fencer touched by God or by whatever are ready to do that, like David. David was amazing, you know.
Yeah. I mean,
then he have a hard team.
As they say, don't try this at home.
Yeah, don't try this at home. Really, you are right. But David have a good team, a strong team that support him in the team event. But individual, he makes all alone.
He did it himself.
Yeah. He didn't. Nobody's coming to this to you.
So are you staying for the foil?
No. I'm leaving tomorrow. I'm coming back to Madrid tomorrow. Yeah, I had the license in foil too. But the FIE decided that a lot of us just make and work in various weapons. I make épée and saber. There are another that make saber and foil. There are another that make épée and foil.
Right.
So that all of us are here like a big group, and doesn't matter if you are. For me, it's better go home because I start to be tired.
Yep.
And when the referee is tired, it's not good for the fencer. You know, you are not fresh.
We've got one more gold medal match and one more world champion to crown. We're going to see Russia again. This time they'll be up against Italy, and it is the men's junior men's saber team match, and another great matchup here.
Yeah.
For Russia, it will be Vladislav Pozniakov, Anatoly Kostenko, the two-time junior world champion Konstantin Lokanov. And in reserve, it will be Mark Stepanov for Italy.
An amazing team. there are people on that team.
Alberto Arpino. Matteo Neri. Giacomo Minuzzi. And in reserve, Raffaele Minischetti. And our referees for this match, Min Kao of China and Vasil Malenchev of Bulgaria, Anlar Bertier and Alexandra Echevarria of Mexico will be our assessors for this match. So,
in the Russian team, there are two people that already fans in the Russian team senior, like Lokanov and Poznikov.
Yeah.
Are used to use fencing in the senior team. So this gives you a view about how strong is this team. In the other side, Italians.
Well,
young team.
We've watched them before. I called the match between Russia and Romania.
Yeah.
Russia was lucky to get out of that match.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I didn't see.
Romania, it was 45-42. Was the final score, and the Romanians were running the Russians ragged. We know they can be beat. They are a great team, and you've got a two-time world champion, and just every one of them is incredibly strong. The Italians, you never write off an Italian team ever.
And in Verona less.
Yeah, in Verona less, but.
I remember Matteo Neri was injured in the top 16 match against Canada. He quit in the top 8. The Italian don't use it. And he come back to the team from the semi-final with US. Because he's the head of that team is Matteo. About the Russian, it's a strong team, but you win the championship, you win the matches in the piste, not over the papers. So I expect that we are going to see a great, great match.
I think so. It's really difficult when you see the Russian team fence. Did the Russian team get in trouble against Romania? They did, but they also won.
Yeah, they France.
Did the Russian team get, in the women's saber team get in trouble against the U.S.? They did, but they won. And it's hard for me to see us not hearing the Russian national anthem twice, but Italy's got something to say about that, and I'm curious to know what it is. Minuzzi to start for Italy, Lokanov for Russia.
Yeah, great parallel report from Minuzzi.
Now, Lokanov looking to the bench. Will he ask for a video review?
The coaches said that don't ask. Two great coaches in the Russian side, Alexey Frosin and Shirshov, two incredible save offensive in other times, that for sure give his experience to that team. Well, it looks like the Italian are more ready than Russian right now.
It's not very often that you see Lokanov in this position.
Yeah.
Down 4-1.
In the team event, it's very important to close the matches. If you are 4-1, it's really important to close 5-1. Because for your colleague that's coming later,
yeah,
it's very important to have that difference. Because there are fencers that when they are 4-0, 4-1, they relax themselves and don't fight like at the beginning. So maybe they won the league like 5-4, 4-3, but it's not the same like 5-1.
Right.
But they don't keep keep pushing. You have to fight like the last.
Minozzi building a long and confident attack, and that will end the first 5-2. And the Italians have come to play.
Yeah.
You know, this is just the first of nine, but let's see what Matteo Neri brings as Vladislav Pozniakov is now out for Russia.
What a surname, man, to have in the jacket, Pozniakov.
Yeah, it seems to me like I've heard of some guy before that.
There was a guy. There was a guy that was strong.
Yeah.
A little bit.
He was a pretty good saber fencer,
wasn't he? Yeah.
Is he five-time world champion? Is that what it was?
Yeah, five-time world champion, five-time Olympic gold medalist.
Yeah.
I don't know how much World Cups.
Wait, he's also the president of the European
Confederation.
Great man. And a great guy.
He's a great man. He was a great man when he was on the piste, and he right now out of the piste is a great man too. But what a surname for that man, eh? Pozniakov. That jacket, great.
But you know, that jacket, that name on that jacket also carries a lot of sort of responsibility and a lot of expectations too, doesn't it?
It's like a Spiderman, not? A great power means a great
responsibility, that's right.
Pare. Looks like the ankle of Matteo, it works properly. So we will see a good match. Attack the gauche. Great Vasil.
Matteo Neri asking for a video review here.
I think no chance. Vasil was, for me, from here, I'm up of the stadium and I don't have the same point of view of the referee, but from here, looks like Vasil was right, as almost always. He's a very experienced referee. Russia is back.
Yeah, lovely there from Matteo Neri to close out the second.
Yeah.
Italy still feeling confident here, and it's a close match, and we're not anywhere.
It was 6-5 for the Russia, yeah.
Oh. Yeah, 6-4 Pozniakov, 5 for Neri. We go to the third, Anatoly Kostenko on for Russia, Alberto Arpino for Italy. For Kostenko, and this is Min Kiao of China.
Going
to referee now for the next two legs.
Good. Oh, great. Good movement from Kostenko. Reprise the attack on the left side. Ask for the video, but.
And what is he looking for?
the Italian ask about the give a simultané, but for the Chinese referee means that he feel that the restart of Kostenko, it was a little bit before of the Italian, so, and he keep his decision. No. In the Italian bench, you can see Giovanni Sirovic and another Greek champion, Gigi Tarantino.
Luigi Tarantino is a household name in Italy.
Yeah. But now, as coach, he's more quiet as a fencer.
That's good. Kostenko not happy with the call, but it matters not. He's used his challenge.
He's coming crazy, Kostenko. He tried to do. Nice close right now in the fourth. Touch and then go to close the opening blade in the fourth parade.
And Kostenko beside himself here.
But Basil is coming to calm the guy. Basil saw his experience.
And but, I mean, Kostenko's on a yellow card.
Yeah.
Perry Kostenko, Arpino looks to the box and says, okay.
No way, it was a clear priority post. Like this one.
Like that one, yeah. Arpino just takes one step in. He stayed in too close, had his arm back and stepped in, and Kostenko just whacked him.
A couple of centimeters close. No more.
Well, lead switches hands now. It is Russia. Kostenko with 7, Arpino with 4, so 15-14. Russia in the lead. We go to the fourth, and Pozniakov is back on for Russia, and Giacomo Minuzzi is on for Italy.
Giacomo saw a great fence in the first boat. Mm. We will see right now.
They're both big, aren't they? They're both very tall.
Yeah. Over 190 each, I think. It was yellow card. Did you see how many yellow card for false start are coming? A lot of yellow card for false starts.
In this match?
Yeah. No, even during the day.
Oh, yeah.
So the fencer uses this trick. He has to take a little advantage in the attack.
Call stands.
Tarantino is coming out from the box.
That's never a good thing.
Yeah, that is not good.
Yeah, the Italians are getting very exercised now. And the Russians are putting their stamp on this. And Anlar Berthier, the assessor on the Italian side, has come over. And Minuzzi's strap on his jacket has come unstuck.
Tarantino is giving some advice at the same time he put the strap on the jacket.
Yeah. What do you think he's going to do?
I don't know. I don't know because...
It may take a few minutes for him to actually get the strap connected.
Yeah. You know, some tricks, they can use it.
They keep finding these things on the piece. All day today, they keep finding these bits on the piece.
Yeah.
And nobody's ever been able to figure out what they are, but they're sort of big white plastic things, I guess.
Rest maybe a table, the Zeus or whatever.
Minuzzi, looks like he took a whack to his non-weapon hand.
Maybe.
That can hurt.
Yeah, they had to call the doctor because maybe there is blood over there. Don't want the doctor, Minuzzi, because the referee asked about and he said not. Okay, call. Call because there are blood. And who knows how much we'll do in this boat. So another ex-Sabre fencer, you can see Jeremy Summers. Now
the doctor.
The doctor. He was a good Sabre fencer in junior categories. Yeah.
Yeah.
Was the pre fencer before the great Keith Smart and Ivan Lee and all that generation. He's now 40. Yes, he's on my age, the same age. He's 41 this year, or 40, something like that. And now he come back to the fencing as doctor, and he make a great job. I think all the people that was fencer and can help the fencing develop are great. And he's doing.
Well, having been a saber fencer, he's gonna know what the injury is.
Yeah. Now we look in the TV that the Valentina Vezzali is in the hall. Yes, cheering the Italian team, a big champion too, a very big champion.
Well, we've not had the start of the injury clock, which is good.
Yeah.
All right.
Remember that if there are an injury, more bigger, they have 5 minutes to fix it.
Pozniakoff looking for the parry there and does not find it. Minuzzi's going to want to pull back as many points here as he can.
He's on fire too.
Okay. Nothing given there. First attack, no, from Pozniakoff.
I think Kiao is right. It was like that. He's going to confirm. Maybe Vasil has something to say. Because Pozniakoff is going to look for the paré. Yeah. He tries to cheat right now.
Well, a few minutes ago.
There were 1914 or 1915, I think.
Yeah, 1914. And this is now a whole different ball game. Now Italy has come back in the lead.
Yeah. Now here you can say the important that we said before about the close the matches.
Yeah.
When you are on the last touch. If you relax yourself, can happen this, that you are 1914, just one touch to close the leg. And instead of that, the Italian come back and close for Italian people on the first.
We go to the 5th, 2019, and that was a busy fourth leg, but it was busy in the head,
yeah,
as much as it was busy on the piste. And so we go to the 5th, Lokanov and Arpino.
This is important match. If Lokanov can switch the situation, that will leave Russia lead for 3 or 4 touches, maybe. You will see.
The final action, parry for Lokanov.
Great distance for Lokanov. Great distance. He keep in the same distance to the fencer. Don't leave him develop his attack, and at the end go back to make him miss the touch. Look at that. I told you, 23-20. Lokanov know that this match is pretty important for his team, and he's doing great.
First attack, no. And
we will check. But I think Vasily is right.
Let's see the replay. Oh. And what does Vasil Malenchev have to say?
Yeah, and Lokanov understand. Lokanov understand perfectly. And another counterattack. Too long, this Russian. Too long. Four touches, by the way, leading Russian right now.
All right, that will take us out of the 5th, and a big swing back in the other direction. Only one in that for Arpino, 6 in there for Lokanov. And where will the wheel stop is what the question is.
Yeah.
We go into the 6th, and it will be Kostenko on against Neri, and both fairly emotional fencers, would you not say?
Neri right now is in the same situation as Lokanov, the bout before. Right now, Neri knows that the for Italian team, this bout is completely necessary to be back in the game.
Right.
And he's doing his best for sure. I saw a lot of comments from series of Charles. That I think is Andrew Fitch. It was another saber fencer from US. I saw in the YouTube channel. Are you Andrew? She was a charge.
It's a lot of fencers.
Yeah.
Watch and leave comments.
I'm impressed about that, eh? out.
Yeah, he's gone over the back line.
Yeah.
Neri giving up a fight. Actually, I saw him do that earlier today. That's, in fact, if I think about it, I think I may have seen him do it a couple of times today. And not something you can afford to do in a gold medal match, especially not when you're facing Russia. So, you know, Italy turned things around.
Kostenko make a great, great boat. Amazing.
Well, in the last leg, Arpino only had one. Here, Neri only has two. And I feel like things may be slipping away from Italy. They've got to reach down now. It's the seventh. And it is...
Hello, Peter. Hello, Andrew, excuse me. So fun.
And there is no room for error here for Italy. It is Minaschetti, the reserve, is in for Arpino. Arpino, in his last outing, only had one. So Minaschetti in to see if he can fire things up. There's one.
Rossien said to the fencer, ask for the video. They are going to check. Kiao gives attack from the Italian side. And Basile confirm. Check it again, but Basile confirms the decision of Kiao.
Lovely there from Pozniakov.
Yeah, great parry riposte, fourth.
Just stepping into it, and powerful from Minaschetti.
Minaschetti come in the top eight against, I don't remember who fenced against Italy in the top eight, but after the injury of Neri, Minaschetti go and fence in the top eight, and he makes great. So he can do as well as Arpino, for sure.
I'll tell you what, you can tell he's come to fight, and Pozniakov getting the parry there, but this is a big battle.
Yeah, it's a bit different too in the touches. The last two boats will be enough for the Russian team. Okay. We'll see if the Italian team come back or not. They are going to try for sure.
Right, so this is our reserve in the seventh. Then we have Minuzzi in the eighth, Neri to close.
Yeah.
Coming up, we're going to have Kostenko and Lokanov. Minaschetti is going to have to pull back some points here.
They are trying. He's trying. He's trying hard. Right now, I think it's 4-3 for him in 5-3 already.
Yeah.
Pozniakov stopped the match. Now he's losing some touches on a roll, and he decided to change his saber. He has to have some fresh air and think about what is happening in the last touches.
Well, you know, he can't do his hair.
Yeah.
You got to do something.
Yeah, but this, the change the saber is the it's a typical one. The Zeus too. What are the Zeus? I can make the Zeus again? Okay, okay.
Yeah.
If you were fencer, you understand what happened when you are referee. And you understand what they are doing. I mean, it's Katie. It's coming up.
Separation there.
Polnikov want to close, but if you want to close, you have to take risk. And he take it, and he lost the touch.
But we had this before. We had this before with Pozniakov, where he was sat on, I believe it was Pozniakov. He was sat on 19.
Yeah.
And he got chased down.
And Minuzzi come back to 20. And now he closed 35-30. Two touches up for Minuzzi. I think he make great job coming from the bench.
Oh, absolutely.
Plus two.
But if we go into the eighth and Minuzzi cannot lose any points.
Yeah.
And maybe pick up a couple of points.
That would be great for Italians.
Then going into the ninth, you know, Neri and Lokanov is going to be a big battle.
Yeah.
And
if Minuzzi can make like 7-8 touches, could be great for Matteo. But I saw Kostenko quite focused in the game before, in the boat before. Against Neri. He make 5-2, I think, in the ball before against Neri, so Kostenko is so focused.
Well, Minuzzi went early.
Oh, so Alain Berthier said that the Russian start before the Allais. So now Vasilis explained to him about and give a yellow card for the Russian and quit for Italian, I think. Yeah. So right
well,
now...
Well, that's an interesting turn.
Yeah. Yeah, could be. Kostenko, I think he takes yellow card all the three matches on this final for false start. That means that he uses it a lot. Oh, it's close. It's very close. Kjell thinks that the time that tried the Russian don't get enough time fencing and give the attack of Minuzzi and again. As everybody expected, the two finals of today are pretty great, I think. And now, what happened? Oh, Minuzzi started before, so he gets a yellow card too.
Well, if this goes Minuzzi's way,
Minucci have to make at least four touches more, at least.
Yeah. But we're also assuming, we're assuming that Kostenko is going to close out at 40.
Now looks like Minucci it's more on fire than Kostenko.
Yeah.
Kostenko started good with the first touch, it was good. But now I think he lost a little bit his confidence. Kostenko is a good player in, he makes a lot of pares and he feels very well the blade. So his fencing is about that. But Minucci is attacking pretty well.
They are really going at each other.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And again and again.
Minucci looks like he's chopping firewood. He looks like he's trying to break Kostenko.
Yeah.
Nothing as given, and now Kostenko trying to get a video review.
But I don't think the Russian still have one challenge, and they are going to use right now. Kostenko feels that his attack, it was on perfect fencing time. And it looks like. So I think Kiao is going to give, yeah.
Well, Minucci went looking for a parry, and he was in a really, really difficult place to try and do that.
Yeah. Okay. Minucci needs more points. Right now it's 5-4 for him, but he needs more than five. A 5-5 in this leg, it's not enough for the Italian team. The Italian asking for the video. The attack was for Kostenko for sure. Then they had to decide if first hit on the wall or directly in the body of Minucci. So Basile checking. And he give the touch and keep the decision of Kiao.
All right, well, we go into the ninth and final leg. There's been no net gain for anybody here. 40-35. We came in at 35-30. We go out at 40-35, and it is Lokanov to close for Russia, Matteo Neri for Italy, and that is a very, very tall hill to climb for the Italians. Can anybody do it? The Italians can.
Yeah, they
will
can do it.
Will they be able to do it? We'll have to see.
We have to say right now. I think Matteo is a good, really good fencer. What about Lokanov? He's 2 times world champion. But this will be a great, great boat.
Vasil Malenchev.
Give the attack to Lokanov.
It is in to referee our final leg.
Lokanov is also a very intelligent fencer. He knows perfectly when he touch and when he's touched. And it was 2 times in a row right now, and he knows.
Distance really, really well here.
Yeah, Lokanov start to feel the breath of Neri behind him. He's not that far, huh? Three touches.
Two touches, and Lokanov maybe feeling some nerves.
I think so. It's a lot of responsibility. You are fencing for Russia. Russia, during the years, become a great champion, and that you had to feel it. In the other way, it's Neri that fencing for Italia, that is already a champion. Yeah. That who managed better this situation is going to win. Attack the draw. Good.
Right now, it's looking like Matteo Neri.
I saw behind me Valerio Aspromonte that is so nervous right now.
Yeah, that's right. We've got Valerio Aspromonte and Giorgio Caruso just behind us.
Yeah, they are. Valerio is so nervous right now. It's already a stand up watching the match. It's great. Attack from the right side, right? 43-42. It's a new game right now.
Matteo Neri on a 7-point run.
I'm 43-43.
This place is going to go crazy.
Yeah. Remember that Lokanov have a problem today with the French team in the top eight. He was leading 44-36,
yep.
And at the end it was 44-44.
Yeah. And he's sound. Right, he's right back in the same position.
Yeah. Whoa! Amazing, Matteo Neri.
Italy is in the lead. They came in.
They become world champion.
40-35.
7-3, by the way, for Matteo Neri.
If he pulls this off.
Whoa, man.
44-44. Here we are, gold medal match.
What a couple of finals we have tonight.
This is amazing. This is really amazing.
44
Nine
both.
Points from Matteo Neri in the ninth and final leg. And now we're tied at 44. Vasyl Malinchev has to go to the video before he can make a call. They're both lobbying heavily.
Now Basile and Kiao are looking the video again. And again, checking if there will be enough fencing time for Matteo Neri or will be a simultaneous. They checking again. It's a very, very tight action.
What's it going to be? Vasyl Malinchev is coming back. Maybe it's nothing. Maybe it's everything.
What will happen, David? And it was simultaneous. Great, Vasyl.
Nothing given. Oh, and we're going to have this tension every exchange.
And now it's okay. Now Matteo Neri come back with eight touches in the last leg.
We've got Luigi Tarantino out there pulling the fencers apart. He's like, get off.
They've
broken the piece.
They have to check the referees. And Now the fencers are waiting on the piece, but everybody knows what happened right now. Basile go to the piece and stand up his right arm right now. Italy world champion.
Oh my. They're scratching their heads over on the Russian side.
They are at home, and David. They are at home. They trust in themselves. And yeah. They take the goal.
Just amazing. Italy, our 2018 junior men's sabre world champions. And what kind of match was that? That was just amazing.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
we've seen some great matches before, but what was that?
Yeah, amazing, amazing final. Amazing final. We have every day tonight. We have nervous, great actions, people that fans like crazy today, and other people that unexpected fans less that we thought he go to fans at the beginning, but now, whoa. Well, I have a great feeling today after this.
Yeah, I mean, this is just amazing. And you know what? Lokanov has got to do something about this. It's a problem. He's young. He's under 20.
Yeah.
And so any developing athlete that gets to the top, and especially gets to the top early, has got a lot of things that they need to work on and develop. And handling pressure is something that he's got to do, because he is a great champion.
Yeah, I think after this competition today, they for sure, and his coaches for sure do too, they are going to take him and go probably to a psychology to know how to win or how to close the teen event competition. Because today looks like he still didn't learn, because they have problems against Romania, they have problems against France, they have problems against Italy. So that means that he have to work in this side to be a great champion that it will be due, for sure.
You've got to finish.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's not to take anything away from a really brilliant victory from Italy.
Of course.
That was an Italian victory.
Yeah. The classical Italian victory, coming back from the end of the times to the top, is a classical for them.
Well, we've got a couple of medal ceremonies coming up. So before we say goodnight to you, Ignacio, I want to say thank you very, very much. And what's next on your, where are you off to next? You go to Madrid tomorrow.
I'm going to Madrid tomorrow. I will be for sure in Madrid World Cup as referee, and will be for sure in Moscow too. I have designation for that two competition. And then finish the season. It's enough.
Is it?
Is there
ever enough?
No. It's going from Spain, it's going Vanessa Chichon, a great referee that make a great job in the FIA in EPE, and she was a sabre fencer, so he's a great referee too in sabre fencer.
Okay,
so
great.
So she's going there, and for sure she's doing great.
Excellent. Well, I will see you. I hope to see you very, very soon. I can't thank you enough for coming in tonight. I hope you had a great time.
Yeah, I passed a great time, man. It was amazing. At the beginning, I was a little bit afraid about what I'm going to say, because my English is not very good. But during the finals, I start to feel more confidence. I start to feel good. And I have a great time, man. Thanks to you.
Excellent. Well, we will have you back.
Oh.
Because you're great fun.
Okay, I will do it.
Okay, great.
Thanks, David.
Thank you. Ignacio Nacho Casares of Spain. Great referee, great fencer. And love having him here tonight. We're going to take a short break. We've been talking for a long, 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 long time. And we've got to talk a little bit more when the medal ceremonies come up. So stay with us. We'll be back. We're going to crown two new world champions. Here we go. Two more world champions to crown. We can tell you what the prize money is, as they, during junior team competitions, gold, each member of the gold medal team receives a prize of $1,250, $800 for each member of the silver medal team, and $500 each for the bronze medalists. Not a bad day's work. And out they come. Presenting the medals tonight will be Bert Vandefleer, member of honor of the FIE, and the head of our fair play group here, Valentina Vitzali, and Ms. Andrea Migliorenzi, president of EMEA, one of the sponsors. And the team from Italy, Giulia Arpino, Lucia Lucarini, Beatrice Dalla Vecchia, and Claudia Rotilli. For Italy. And our silver medalist from the USA, Zara Moss, Edith Johnson, Elizabeth Tartakovsky, and Chloe Fox Gittmer. And Valentina Vitzali, hanging a medal around your neck is, under any circumstances, a truly great honor. At our 2018 Junior Women's Sabre Team Champion, the team from Russia, Evgenia Podpeskova, Alina Mikhailova, Olga Nikitina, a double gold medalist at this World Championships, and Valeria Kobzeva. Bert Vandefleer delivering the medals and prizes. Thank you. And now it will be time once again for us to hear the Russian national anthem. All please rise.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of Russia. Signore, signori, ascoltiamo l'inno nazionale della Russia.
Congratulations to our new women's saber team world champions from Russia, silver medalist USA, and bronze medal to Italy, and our fourth place team, Korea. A great day of fencing for all of them and for all of the teams. I think we had 23, 24 teams in the competition today from all over the world. And it's, you know, it's not only an honor to be able to compete for your team at the World Championships, just to participate and that is an honor in itself, as we say each and every night. And while we get ready for our next medal presentation, just like to remind you again about Donate Your Fencing Gear program that's being run by the FIE. We started this a year ago in Plovdiv at the Junior Cadet and Junior World Championships, and we carried on with that in Leipzig at the World Senior World Championships. And it's expanded now, and they've been doing a really great thing here. And the countries that are the beneficiaries of the Donate program are Benin, Burkina Faso, Ecuador, Mexico, Samoa and American Samoa, the Philippines, Paraguay, and Morocco. And each one of these countries submitted a plan for what the equipment will go for, what it will do to help people become involved in the sport of fencing, and how it can help young people discover our sport and grow our sport and learn the great things that we have all learned from participating in the sport. So I said last night, I'll say again, I'm going to say for the next three nights, if you're here, and we know that, you know, fencers go and watch the replay afterwards. I want to say, if you're here, if you've been lucky enough to come to the World Championships, when you're going home, stop by the Donate Your Fencing Gear stand and leave something behind. Leave something behind for someone in a country that's not as lucky as you, and someone that you would like to share your gift of fencing with. And it's a great thing to do, and something that that will help a lot of people. This is our final night of saber fencing. We had three nights of épée, and 3 days and nights of saber. And tomorrow, we're going to start a whole new round. Every time we get to the team events in this competition, I think, well, that's it. No, that's not it. We've got three more days. Tomorrow we pick up women's and men's junior foil, and it's going to be that's going to be a long day. We've got 196 men's foilists, 142 women's foilists. It's all going to kick off at 8:30 in the morning. We're not on the air until 3:00 in the afternoon. It's going to take that long to get through the preliminaries. So at 3:00 in the afternoon tomorrow, Verona time, we'll start with the women's foil round of 32. 4:10 in the afternoon, we will pick up the men's foil round of 32 and carry on through the afternoon and into the evening. Our first semifinal is at 7 p.m. Our first gold medal match is at 8:10. And we're going to finish up about 9:00 tomorrow night. So another long day. But we're going to shift gears. If you love foil, this is the place to be, because we're going to have junior men's and women's foil, followed the next day by cadet men's and women's foil, and then a big bang of a finish for this World Championships with the men's and women's foil team championships. All right, time for the men. They come. In the junior team competitions, each member of the gold medal team receives a prize of $1,250, with $800 for each member of the silver medal team and $500 for each member of the medal. Please welcome the three medal presenters.
And presenting tonight will be Mr. Alfredo Rota, ambassador of the Verona 2018 Championships, Mr. Paolo Azzi, vice president of the Italian Fencing Federation, and Giorgio Scarzo, president of Fedescherma, the Italian Fencing Federation, and member of the executive committee of the FIE. And our bronze medal tonight goes to the team from the USA: Andrew Dotto, Erwin Kai, Kamar Skeet, and Mitchell Sarum. And their coach is Zoran Tulum, who has been so great with us up here for our first 2 days of the Saber competition. He was too busy tonight collecting a medal. But we're really happy we had Ignacio Casares with us. That's for sure. Silver medal goes to Russia. It's gonna be pretty difficult for them to stand on that silver medal spot. Vladislav Pozniakov, Anatoly Kostenko, Konstantin Lukanov, and Mark Stepanov. That was a tough, tough, tough loss for them tonight, but you know what, it's a silver medal, and they have fought well all day, and this is a really hard competition, men's saber team. They'll be back. You know they will.
in our 2018 men's saber team world champions. A great team from Italy, delighting the home crowd. Alberto Arpino, Matteo Neri, Giacomo Minuzzi, and Raffaele Meneschetti, the whole group of them got out there and fought and fought and fought until they won. And when they did, in dramatic fashion, we've had so much excitement today that I'm actually barely able to stand. But, you know, that was an awesome, epic match. And Giorgio Scarzo, just as proud as he could be to hang those medals on his fencers' necks. Again, here at Verona, the Italian national anthem, Fratelli d'Italia, all please rise. Well done to our new world champions from Italy, silver medalists from Russia, bronze medalists from the USA, and our fourth place team, a bright young team from the USA, from Great Britain. Congratulations to all of them, to all of the teams. We had, I think, something like 48 teams that started the day today. It's certainly a long day. You know, I have to say it every time. If you were lucky enough to be able to compete for your country at the World Championships, you're pretty darn lucky. Congratulations to all the fencers, and again, I remind all the fencers that when it's time for you to go home, be sure and leave something with the Donate Your Fencing Gear program and pass along your good fortune to people in countries that want to learn fencing and need a leg up to be able to do that. That's it for Sabre. We've gone through Epee, we've gone through Sabre, we've crowned all the world champions we can up to this point. It all kicks off again tomorrow. We start 3 days and nights of great foil fencing here at the Junior and Cadet World Fencing Championships. And all of that starts at 8:30 in the morning with the men's and women's foil pools and preliminaries. We will join you at 3 p.m. Verona time tomorrow afternoon with all of the action from the round of 32 on until we crown two more world champions. So we're all a little tired, and we need to get some rest so we can keep bringing this program to you. So we are going to say good night. We say thank you very much to Ignacio Casares for his great help this evening. And so for everybody at the FIE and our organizing committee and Fetiskerma who have made all of this possible, I'm David King, and I say thank you and good night, and we'll see you tomorrow for another great day of great fencing action. This is the FIE Fencing Channel live presentation of the 2018 Junior and Cadet World Fencing Championships. Good night. See you tomorrow.